Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm gonna talk a little bit about React, Angular and native JavaScript and web components. And this is prompted from a question I got from Fazil on YouTube. He or she asked if there were any ways to integrate your own web component with Angular or React or any other framework, and how to do that, and if it's easy, hard, and so on. So I thought I'd go through how to set up an environment with React, for instance, and how to use my web component VC input in that React app. And I have a video where I actually built this VC input, so you can look at that if you like. It's a stream, so it's a bit longer. And then I'm gonna go through how to set it up in Angular. And lastly, we're gonna look at how to use it in a VanillaJS app. So in order to do this in a React app, we need to create a React app. So we start by this, creating my React app. And this can take some time to run. So now I've installed the React app. And when we have done that, we need to go into my React app and we need to npm install my web component. So we install the VC input component. And that will take some while as well. Yeah. So now we have installed all the dependencies. So we have my React app up and running, and we have my web component here, this VC input. So now we're gonna run it in React. And to do that, we need to find my component. So we go into the source folder here, we go into the app component here. And in order to use it, we need to import it firstly. So we add an input at the top here for our component, like that. And then we need to copy in our component somewhere in the structure here. So let's say that we put it last in the code here. So this is a VC input with a label enter name. And when we have done that, we can actually start it, because React app doesn't use any extra cache to look into what kind of components are allowed or not allowed. So you can just insert any component and it will use that component. And if it doesn't find it, it will just tell the browser that I don't know anything about this. What do you make of it? So let's run npm start here. And we will start up our node server here, and we will get something up and running on port 3000. So let's open up our web browser here and open that up here. And here we see we have React running and we have my little VC input here up and running as well. So it worked just fine in React just to start it up. So let's go back to the editor here and try the Angular example up. So in order to run Angular, you need firstly to install the Angular CLI. So we'll do that. Now we have the Angular CLI. And when we have that, we can create a new Angular app running ng new and the name of our new application. So I go from my React app and then I create a new application out here. Okay, so the node version I'm using is not supported. There we go. Let's try this again with the new version 8. So I installed, I believe, node on this machine 1 year ago, and then the long-term supported version was 6 point something, and Angular requires 8.9 at least, and 8.12 is the current LTS version. So if you are downloading the current node version that they have long-term support for, you should be just fine running Angular. But as I'm having a bit of an older version of Node, I was not able to run it out of the box, but I've updated and now we can run it. So let's wait for this installation. So there we go. Now we have the Angular application created. So I will go into my Angular app here and do an npm install vc input. So I will install my component again on my Angular app. And there we go. Now we have installed that as well. And Angular is a little bit more distributed. So you have all your modules and all your components separated in different JavaScript files. So if we go into our source folder here, you should find in the app folder a lot of files. One of them is app module. So you have a module which has component in it. So if we look here, we should first go to the app module and add the custom schema. This should be added to the import statement for Angular Core. So let's go into the app module here, and we have the import statement up here and ng module from Angular Core. So we add a comma and the custom element schema there, so we can use that. And then we need to add the schema declaration to our module down here. So we say that we want to run this module with a schema as well, and this custom element schema. And that's because Angular has a cache that looks up which components are valid Angular components, which components are actually available to use. And if you don't say to Angular that this module will have custom elements in this module, then it will not recognize those custom elements or will not tell the browser to actually use those, so you can't actually find them in your code. So that's the first thing you need to do. Then you go into your component TypeScript file here, and here we need to import our component. So we import it in the TypeScript file, so the JavaScript file, and in this case TypeScript file, so the actual code there, you import your component so Angular knows about that component and can actually use it. And last but not least, we need to add the actual declaration of the component, and this we put in our template. So in our template we will tell it where to use our VC input. So the app component HTML is the template, and we have some image here, and I think below the image I will put my VC input. So that's what we need to do in order to put it into an Angular component. And in order to run Angular, you run ng serve open, and that will open the Angular application in your web browser. And so let's see when this have run. It will compile all our module and compile all our source code and prepare it to show it. And here we have our Angular app, and here we have my little component, and we can enter some data there and type and so on. I haven't actually specified what font I want to use in my component, and as you see here, you actually have some bleed through there, so it will in the different application change what the look of the actual component will be. But you can build into your component to actually set the font and so on, so you have a specific unique styling on those. And last but not least, I want to look at my favorite framework, the vanilla framework, where you just have pure JavaScript source or JavaScript code and pure HTML. And if we go into my Angular, my vanilla JS app. So we look there. This is very simple. Here I have actually an index.html. So this is something that will host my little application here. It's just an express server. It will host the node modules and public. So we can show where public is. In my package HTML here, I have added express for the dependencies and also added VC input as a dependency. So let's install the dependencies for VC input. Should not take that long. So now we have VC input installed. And I have actually built VC input in a way that it actually has a built version as well. And that is compressed and it's just JavaScript. And so I have something that I call VC input min. So that I import into my HTML template here as a script. And then I just use my web component in my body here of my HTML. So that's what you need to do in order to do use your component in a vanilla way without any extra. And let's try to run this. So I just do npm start, I believe. Should start my web server, so it will start on localhost 5001. So if we open up localhost 5001, you should see my application here. And it's not anything fancy, it's just my component and nothing else. So that's three ways of using your web component in different projects. If you want to use it vanilla, you need to actually compile it and you need to some way take your component and add all your dependencies. If you are writing a web component that don't have any dependencies, you can just use them as they are. But in my case, I had a dependency on lit.html and so on. And then I needed to compile it in some way to use it. So I have a compiled version in my component. But in Angular and React, they actually compile my component for me. So there I just need to import the component. And the component will go through the standard way of compiling components for React or Angular, and they will do all the heavy lifting for you to actually use your components. So this was what I wanted to talk about today. With all the installing and everything, this video is about 35 minutes long, so that's how long I spent to actually make this happen. So I think it's quite easy to get it up and running if you have some component that you want to use. I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that I answered the question. If you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comment section down below. And I really hope to see you in the next video.